The Mr. Excel podcast is sponsored by the book Mr. Excel XL. Learn Excel from Mr. Excel podcast, episode 1983. Change all sheets with group mode. Well, hey, back in episode 1981, I showed you how to very quickly create sheets. Remember, control drag. And so while we build a report here for January, we're able to make copies incredibly quickly. But unfortunately now, we're violating a business rule that you may have heard of called the manager 15-minute rule. Well, actually, you may not have learned this in business school because I think I made it up. And it goes like this. It says if your manager comes in and asks you to do something for a task, it usually is about 15 minutes later the manager comes back and says, you know, hey, I changed my mind. I need you to do something different. But, you know, now the problem is because we can make sheets so quickly that instead of having to make one change, we would have to make, in this case, 12 changes, January through December. All right, I'm going to show you a trick that is incredibly powerful, but incredibly, incredibly dangerous. So I start here on the January sheet, and I'm going to shift click on December. All right, and what that has done, you can see up here, we now say that we are in group mode. So even though we're looking at January, any changes that we make are happening to all of the sheets in the group, right? So maybe the manager says, look, I need the totals highlighted in bold. So I do control B there, control B, and we need to edit this January report. I want to call it sales report for January. So I go into edit mode and up here say sales report. Actually, let's scream it all caps. For ampersand, and then I don't need the report at the end. Use upper there. All right, that looks good. And you know, he wants that in some other color, maybe a nice deep blue. All right, so there we've made the change for January, but it is actually done the same change in all of the sheets in the group. All right, now the reason that this is so dangerous is that every time that I go into group mode, my telephone rings, and it's not a short call. It's someone with some complicated thing, or maybe even my manager, you know, who gives me 15 minutes worth of things to do, and I come back from that call, and I sit here, and I realize that I'm looking at the sales report for January, and I start changing numbers in January. And the problem with that is, although I think I'm working on the January report, I'm actually screwing up all of the numbers on all of the other reports in the group. I mean, let's face it, it's really subtle. The sheet tabs down here aren't that different in color, and really small up there, really out of your sight that you're in group mode. So my actual real-life tip here is a tip that really doesn't have to do anything with Excel. It's just that I've been burned by this so many times. Every time that I go into group mode, I have a sticky note on my wall. I stick that sticky note on the monitor. It says, Bill, you are in group mode, right? Just because once you've been burned by this, it is a painful, painful thing. Now, the question, how do you get out of group mode? All right, there's a couple of different ways. If all of the sheets are not selected, then you can just click any other sheet in the workbook, and it'll get you out of group mode. But if all the sheets are selected, so I'm going to choose select all sheets, then you just have to choose something that's not the active sheet. So like if I click on February, that would get us out. However, that doesn't work in the case where not all the sheets. So like right now, January through December, if I click on February, that just makes that the active sheet. You have to click outside. So the way that works reliably all the time is to right click the any sheet tab and choose ungroup sheets. I realize it's out of your view there, but that works all the time. Just a bonus tip here, if you needed to select not every sheet, you could choose January and then control click on March and May and July and September and put those in group mode like that. Well, hey, if you're enjoying these tips, go subscribe to the Mr. Excel XL playlist. I'll be podcasting all of the 40 tips in the Mr. Excel XL book. Or hey, you can save time and buy the whole book now. There's a link up there, an eye up in the top right-hand corner. You can buy the whole book now. It's 25 bucks. It's cheap. All these great Excel tips, great reference guide to all of this series of podcasts that we're doing here. All right, episode recap. You learn how to make copies of a sheet quickly back in podcast 1981. The manager 15-minute rule. My creation says every time my manager asks for something, they change their mind 15 minutes later. But now we have to make changes to 12 copies instead of just one. So you select the January sheet, shift-click on December to begin group mode. It changes all of the sheets in the group, but it's easy to get distracted and forget you're in group mode. You know, the phone rings, you get called to a staff meeting, you come back and you see that you're in January, you start overwriting things. There's three different ways to exit group mode. If all the sheets aren't selected, select a sheet that's not in the group. If all the sheets are grouped, then select a sheet that's not the active sheet. Or reliably, no matter how many sheets are selected, right-click the sheet tab and choose ungroup sheets. A lot of the ideas in the book were crowdsourced, so Olga K said in group mode is one of her ideas, so thanks to her. I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.